Hey everyone, if you're new here, welcome. My name is Keisha, and today I'm going to be talking to you about all of the books that I have read with my middle grade book club. So in case you're new here and you didn't already know, I have been hosting a middle grade book club with about 10 really awesome 8 to 12 year olds for almost a year now. This has been my pride and joy, one of my most favorite things in the whole entire world, and something I'm so passionate about. When I started this book club, I had no idea where it was going to go or if it would even take off, but it has been just the biggest blessing to me and one of my favorite things, like I said. So I actually started this book club as the Page Turners when I was a children's librarian, and that was back in October of 2020 that I started the book club. So I'm going to go back all the way to then and tell you about kind of how I ran the book club then, how I run it now, some of the books that we read, and even tell you what some of my kiddos' favorite books were and favorite parties and discussions were. So kind of what birthed this book club was COVID, honestly. So when the pandemic happened, we were quarantined and I was still working at the library, but I was having to do a lot of things virtually. So what I started to do was read online, and I wanted to read some chapter books for some of the kids who were in school or maybe not in school. Like, we had homeschool kids too, so they weren't necessarily like being home from that kind of school. But I wanted to provide something for that age group because there was always an age gap at the library. We had a lot of programs for younger kids and toddlers, and then we had a lot of programs for teens. But we didn't really have anything for that middle tween age gap, and so I wanted to provide some programming for them. So I started off reading a few books. I read a Magic Treehouse book. I believe it was the one where Louis Armstrong was a part of it, where they go back. If you read Magic Treehouse, they go back in history, and it's really cool. So that was the book. I'll pop it up on the screen. I don't remember what it was called at this time, but I read that one, and I read a couple of other books, and then a few other ones that I read was The Mouse and the Motorcycle by Beverly Cleary, and then we also did Night Books by J.A. White. So we did these books on Facebook Live, not as a book club. I just would read a few chapters every few days with them, and we would just read through the books and talk about them. So that was how the book club kind of started, even though it wasn't a book club yet. And then I decided that in October, when we started our programming back up, that I really wanted to try to do a book club. So we created the book club, and the first book that we ever read was Coraline. Now, before I tell you about this, I do want to say that with these book clubs, what I decided to do was I would put together a discussion guide and some fun things to go along with the book. I do have some bookmarks, which I forgot to grab, so I will go grab those now. Okay, sorry if my position changed at all because I did have to get up and come back, but I do have some of the bookmarks here. I'm not going to show you yet, but I created bookmarks for some of the books that we read. That way the kids could have their own bookmark. It would say, they said name of the library and the book club on there. We didn't have a name up until our fourth book, I believe, fifth book. We didn't have a name for our book club, but I let the kids vote, and they voted to be called the Page Turners, and so that is what our book club was called. Now, I did provide, like I said, discussion guides and things like that. I'll pop one up on the screen so you can kind of see. I believe the one I have popped up now is when we read Mr. Popper's Penguins, and so I gave them a discussion guide. I gave them a little word search, and they also got a bookmark to go along with it, and then I would always give them the books. So with the library, we purchased the books and distributed them to the kids for free. So book club was entirely free for them. We allowed them to have a free book, a free party with all kinds of free themed snacks and goodies to go along with that. So now let's just go ahead and get into the books, and I'll tell you a little bit about each of the parties and how different things went. So like I said, the first book was Coraline by Neil Gaiman. This was a book that I chose for them. Eventually they would get to choose their own books, but I chose this to start us out in October of last year because Coraline was one of my favorite books and movies, and I really wanted to share that with the kids in the midst of spooky season. So this is the first book that we read, and then I made them a bookmark to go along with it. So this was the bookmark that I made. Now, I could not sell these or do anything else with these but give these to the kids because copyright, but I wanted to give them something that they could kind of use while they were reading the books and also to keep as kind of a keepsake for the book club. So this one is a Coraline one. It has a picture from the movie. It says, "Be wise, be brave, be tricky," which is part of the movie, well, a quote from the movie and a quote from the book. And then it tells the library name and Middle Grade Book Club on the bottom, so this was just a little keepsake for them. If you don't already know, Coraline is this creepy book about this girl named Coraline who has just moved into a new flat with her parents, and she's not really happy. She feels very alone and neglected. She doesn't like where she's at now. She misses her friends, and then one day she discovers this mysterious door. She tells her mom to check it out. Her mom says, oh, that just goes to the flat next door. It's bricked up. There's nothing there. And then one day Coraline goes to find the door open, and it leads into the other flat and the apartment next door that's empty, and except it's not empty now. Coraline has fallen into this world of perfection, essentially, where she has another mother and another father and all the greatest foods and clothes and just a living situation that's much, much better than she feels like she already has. Except there's something creepy about this. I'm not gonna tell you what it is. If you know, you know. If you don't, you should totally read it for spooky season. But things are not as they seem on the other side of this door, and Coraline has to make some pretty tough decisions. So I love this book so much, and this was a great discussion with my kiddos. This was one of my favorite discussions and parties that we had because I got the kiddos to dress up for Halloween. So I ended up dressing up as Coraline from the movie, and then my kiddos dressed up as different things as well. I'll insert some pictures here. We had button cookies, which if you know, you know, like I said, to go with the theme of the book. We had popcorn. We had like spooky punch. It was really fun. We also played Coraline Bingo, and so we played that with buttons also. It was really fun. This was my personal favorite party, and I think it's just because it was the first one. It was a book that I loved, and I got to share it with my kiddos. We got to have some really awesome discussions about different themes in the book, and we also got to talk about how it's important for kids to experience scary stories and how it enables them to kind of overcome different fears in their lives. So this was my personal favorite that we did. We didn't watch the movie with this one just because I didn't know if it would be too scary for the kids. If they're anything like me, I can read scary books, but I can't watch scary movies. So I didn't want to terrify them since we had 8 to 12 year olds. So we just read the book, but that was my personal favorite. The next month, I let the kids vote on what book they wanted. So what I would do is I would provide 4 or 5 different options for them to choose which book they wanted to read. The kids would then vote on the book that they wanted to read the most, and whichever book received the most votes is the one that won and the one that we would read. So for the following month, we read Mr. Popper's Penguins by Florence and Richard Atwater. Now, I did not enjoy this book quite as much. It was written, I believe, in the 30s. Yeah, in the 30s. And it was, you could tell it was written in the 30s, but the kids really enjoyed it. They got another little bookmark to go with this one as well. And they just love the story. They love the penguins. I had a lot of fun incorporating this with the party. Before I show you pictures from the party, let me go ahead and tell you what this is about. So essentially, you have Mr. Popper, who is a house painter, and Mr. Popper has always dreamed of being an Antarctic explorer, but he has never gotten the opportunity to do that. And then one day, he is sent a box of penguins, and it all goes crazy from there. So he has some penguins in his apartment now. You got Captain Cook, who is one of the main penguins that he just falls in love with, and you just kind of follow their story, and it's really imaginative and cute and quirky and fun and a great book for wintertime. There is also a movie adaptation to this with Jim Carrey. So what we did for the party was we watched the movie and we got to discuss how the book and the movie were similar and different, and there are actually a lot of differences, and in my opinion, I prefer the movie. I love penguins, if you don't already know that about me. I love penguins. So when the kids came in, they came in to a live stream of, I think it was the Monterey Bay Aquarium, where the penguins were there. And so they got to see penguins as they were coming in to the book club and grabbing snacks and everything. So that was really fun to incorporate. Some of the snacks we had were Oreos, because penguins a lot of times are black and white. Then we had Swedish fish and goldfish, because penguins eat fish. And I had it set up kind of like a snowy setup with some penguin books around. So we had a discussion over that, watched the movie, and did all those fun things. So I really enjoyed that one. And then the next one that we did was The Christmasaurus by Tom Fletcher. So we did this one in December, and I haven't found a picture yet, but if I can find a picture of when we met for this one, I'll show you. This was the time where everybody was getting sick, and it was around the holidays, and so people were kind of out of pocket. So we had a smaller group this time, and I don't have a lot of pictures from that time because I'm pretty sure I forgot to take them. So one of my homeschool mamas took a picture for me. So if I can find that, I will pop it up on the screen here in just a second. But this was the book that we read for Christmas. And then we had the Christmasaurus bookmark, which one of the quotes from the book was, "Belief is the most powerful magic there is." So that was their bookmark to go with the book. This was such a fun and heartwarming and adventurous book. If you have not read the Christmasaurus with your kiddos, I highly recommend it. Or even just as an adult, I think it's a really fun book. There are beautiful illustrations throughout. I love the artwork. It's illustrated by Shane Devries, and I think he's probably one of my favorite illustrators just because the artwork is just phenomenal. And this has representation in here as far as someone with a disability, because our main character is in a wheelchair. So that was really nice as well. So this follows William Trundle, and William Trundle wants Santa to bring him a dinosaur, but dinosaurs don't exist. He can't have a dinosaur, or they're extinct or whatever. And so he believes in magic though, and he ends up somehow, you don't know how, but somehow acquiring this dinosaur for Christmas. There's also a mean girl in school. You get to meet Santa Claus. There's a horrible villain called the Hunter that you get to learn about. This was just such a fun book, a great Christmas read. The kids really enjoyed this one. I wish more of them would have gotten to come to the party, but it was a crazy month. So from what I remember of this party, we did a Christmassy bingo, and we used little Christmas flavored kisses, like Hershey's Kisses, and we used those as part of the bingo. So we did that, and then this is when I started doing drawings and giveaways for books. So the Christmasaurus had a second book, and I decided to do a little giveaway. So I would end up buying with my own money. I didn't use library funds for this, because we didn't have a lot to do with anyways. So I would end up buying a couple of copies of different books in the series, or different books that would go along with what we've read, and do little giveaways and door prizes and things like that. So for this particular event, I wrapped them since it was Christmas themed. I believe we had Christmas candy and like Christmas tree cakes and stuff like that, but I can't really remember all of it because, like I said, I don't have a lot of pictures. So this was kind of a crazy sporadic month. We have those sometimes, but this was really fun nonetheless. Another book that we read was The Mystery of Black Hollow Lane, and this book was one of my kids' favorites. I went back and asked them what some of their favorite books that we read were, and this was one that was really popular. So I don't have this book with me because I did get rid of my copy, but I will shoot it up on the screen here. And then also, I have a bookmark that I made for them, and it says, "Mystery creates wonder, and wonder is the basis of man's desire to understand." And that is a quote that was from somebody anonymous, I believe. I don't remember who the quote was by, but it wasn't from the book. And this was their little bookmark for that month. And so The Mystery of Black Hollow Lane is essentially about this girl whose mom is kind of busy. She gets sent off to a boarding school. Her dad's been missing for all these years, presumed dead. She gets sent off to this boarding school and finds out there's a secret society here, and some things with the school might be connected to her dad. So it was a really cool academic mystery, kind of dark academia for middle grade, and the kids really enjoyed this one. I did enjoy this one, but it was a little bit like it left me hanging, and it was really slow throughout most of the book, and then everything kind of happened at the end, and I would have liked a little bit more of certain aspects of the book prevalent as an adult, but the kids absolutely loved this one. So for this party, we had bingo once again. Bingo is one of their favorite things. We did bingo for whoever would win bingo for however many bingos. Like if I had two, I think I had two books most of the time. So I had the second book in the Mystery of Black Hollow Lane series. So I would have two books up for grabs. Whoever got bingos, the first two bingos, would win those books. The kids loved bingo. And we had snacks themed around, like popcorn was for Pop Secret, because you know, you've got a mystery. And then we had Hot on the Trail mix and different things like that. So this was a really fun party as well. Another one of the books that we did, which was this book that I'm about to show you, was the most well-loved book and party that we did. And it took a lot of work, and I don't know that I'll ever be able to top it again, but that was Escape from Mr. Limoncello's Library by Chris Grabenstein. Now, this book is so fun, full of adventure and games and libraries and fun codes to crack and all those sorts of things. This is a story about Kyle, and Kyle learns that the most famous game maker in the world has designed the town's new library, and they are going to have a lock in there, but then they end up having to kind of play this little scavenger hunt game of escape from Mr. Limoncello's library while they're there. And this book is full of literally codes to crack throughout. There are, I can't remember what they're called, like pictograms and things like that. If I can find a picture, I'll show you. But you can kind of play along and try to figure out the different codes along the way, which the kids thought was super fun. There's even a code at the end of the book that you can figure out for and like submit your answer to Chris Gravenstein himself. Also, Chris Gravenstein is honestly just a really awesome author to work with. He ended up sending a couple of book plates, signed book plates that I was able to give to the kiddos to put in their books. So that was really awesome as well. For this event, we had lemon heads for the kids to snack on, and we ended up doing a scavenger hunt. So Chris actually has a scavenger hunt on his website that you can access and print off. It's absolutely free, and you can host your own scavenger hunt or escape from the library. So I split the kids up into two teams, and they got to try to decode everything and escape from the library, which it was mostly just a scavenger hunt, not really an escape room type deal. But they absolutely loved it. It was one of the best things that we've done. We even got to talk about the new library, because the library that I worked at the time was fundraising to build a new facility. And so I got to kind of incorporate that in, since Mr. Limoncello had designed this new library, and I got to show the kiddos the designs for our new library, and I got to ask them, what kind of features would you like to see? And it was just super fun. So that was a great time. This was, like I said, one of the most well-loved. Here is our bookmark that we got for that one. And at this point, we were called the Page Turners. And the quote on here says, "A library doesn't need windows, Andrew. We have books, which are windows into worlds we never even dreamed possible." So I absolutely love making these bookmarks. Anyway, so that was absolutely the most popular book and party that we did. The next book that we read, which was also a favorite, was I, Cosmo by Carly Sirosiak. So we didn't get into a lot of contemporary or realistic fiction, so I wanted to bring up more. This one was really fun because it did have a fantastical element, because this whole entire book is from the perspective of Cosmo the dog. And Cosmo is owned by his human, Max. So Max's parents are on the verge of splitting up, and Max doesn't want that to happen. So he ends up entering entering Cosmo into a dance competition that is going to be televised, and he hopes that this will kind of show his family the importance of all of them staying together and the importance of family and all those fun things. So this deals with some hard-hitting topics, but it does it so, so well. Carly Sirosiak is an amazing author. I'm so excited to read more from her. Like I said, this was also one of my kids' favorites. So we also have another bookmark. This is artwork from another edition of iCosmo. And we have a quote on here that says, "And it occurs to me that I do not have to be fearless. Sometimes worry stays beneath your fur in the small spaces that fear likes to hide. But I do believe that with the right human by your side, it's possible to leap fearlessly into the unknown." So this is super, super cute. Loved this party. We had some really fun snacks for this party. And I always tried to make little place cards for the food so they would know what everything is. So we had potato chips, cheese ruffs, popcorn, and dog bones. So, and then we had water and stuff like that. So that were very much themed around dogs. I loved that. This was another favorite. I believe, did we play bingo at this party? I can't remember if we played bingo at this party or not. I'm telling you guys, we play bingo a lot. I don't think we did at this one, but we might have. I can't remember. But anyways, our discussions are always super fun. I love discussing with the kiddos. I forgot to mention, sometimes I would get discussions from online if I could find some from like Scholastic or anywhere like that. And then sometimes when I couldn't find them, I would just kind of develop my own. But it was always so fun to have the kids talk about the books. I would also give them little book review sheets so they could kind of do ratings. I taught them about star ratings and all those fun things. They got to tell me what their favorite things about the books were, what their least favorite things about the books were. And yeah, just kind of, I asked them questions to get them to think and interact and engage while they were reading. So that was super fun. We've got a couple more books left to talk about and then we'll be done. So another book that we read was The Bicycle Spy. I don't have that one with me, but I will pop it up on the screen. This is a historical fiction that is based around World War II. World War II, I believe. And so we got to talk about the war with this one as well. This was really interesting. I kind of relate this with the book Number of the Stars by Lois Lowry. I think both of these books are great introductions to the war for younger kids. This was the bookmark that I made for this one. I really like I put France because it was set in France in the background with the flag and an airplane and the Eiffel Tower and a little bicycle. And I really liked how I did this bookmark. And it says, always be brave and stand up for what's right. So I really enjoyed doing this with the kiddos. We, like I said, we're trying to branch out from fantasy because the kids really liked fantasy books. So we decided to read historical fiction this month and the kids took it really well. We watched some videos and talked about the war, which is kind of a hard thing to talk about with kids 8 to 12, especially on the younger end, because you kind of don't know how to approach certain subjects with them. But I feel like we had really beneficial conversations and I love that we got to do this through books. This was also one of the months that we kind of just had generic snacks. Some months I was either too busy or I didn't have as good of ideas, so we would have generic snacks some months. But the kids, honestly, they were just really excited to get together and hang out, eat snacks, and talk about books together. Then for our summer reading program, we had a summer reading book club, and we ended up reading G.I. Dogs, Hero Pup of World War I, Sergeant Stubby. And so we got to learn about Sergeant Stubby, which was super fun. He is a hero pup of World War I. He was an incredible dog who did lots of incredible things. You should definitely look into it if you haven't before. This book is a great starter conversation. It's from the perspective of Sergeant Stubby, but it's based off of real accounts. And we got to even watch the Sergeant Stubby movie, which is an animated film. It definitely made me cry. It made some of the kids cry. It was just so good. So we ended up having a breakfast and we had donuts and stuff for this one and it was really fun. So the kids really enjoyed learning about not only the war aspects, but learning about war animals in general. We got to talk a little bit about war animals and things like that, which honestly, animals are usually a super popular subject with kiddos anyway. So this one worked out really well. Oh, and also that was another favorite that was mentioned quite often from my kiddos, because they got to learn about history and they got to learn about a really awesome hero pup. The last book that we read was when I was transitioning out of the library and just into now, which I have announcements coming about now, but I'm not gonna make them in this video. So stay tuned for that. So as I was transitioning, we had already planned to read The Wild Robot by Peter Brown. The library had already purchased the books, the kids had picked them up, and I could not stand the thought of the kids not having the opportunity to still have book club. So I contacted the parents and I told them, hey, the library is not gonna do this one this month at the book club. They canceled the book club, I'm not there anymore. If you guys still wanna do this, I would love to find a place and a time to be able to do this and still talk about the book and have our party. So we did that. And I can't tell you guys how happy it made me and how heartwarming it was, because these kids are my family. They're my life. I love them. I'm passionate about what I get to do with them. I'm passionate about fostering a love of reading with these kids and with other kids in my community. And I can't tell you guys how much it means to me that I get the opportunity, whether I'm at a library or not, to still do this. I'm not gonna cry, okay? So anyways, The Wild Robot, we ended up reading this last month and meeting up together, and we renamed our book club The Book Lights, which has a sweet thing behind it, but I'm not going to go into that here. But we ended up renaming our club The Book Lights, and this was the book that we read, and we're going to continue this on for as long as I'm able to, and I'm just so, so blessed to have these people in my life, these parents, these kids, and this opportunity. So anyways, off of the sob story and the sappiness, The Wild Robot follows this robot named Roz, who is involved in this hurricane. Her boat crashes on the shores of this remote island that has nobody, no people, just animals. And Roz ends up being the only robot to survive. She gets out of this box, gets turned on somehow, and now she's learning how to survive and adapt in the wilderness. So this is a really cool book that talks about different survival instincts and survival tips, animal adaptations and things like that. This is such an awesome book. I love the illustrations throughout. Some of my kiddos said it was creepy. Here's one that's not creepy for you. If I can find a creepy one, I'll show you. But the kids, oh my gosh, they love this so much. And one of my kiddos, I think I mentioned this in a video previously, was like, why does Roz always stand like this, like she's gonna kill somebody? And I'm like, oh my gosh, these kids and their imaginations, it's great. But I mean, in all honesty, Roz does kind of look a little intimidating there. So This is a really great book. I'll pop up some pictures now. We ended up having some really fun snacks for this one as well. So we had wires, which were Twizzlers, nuts and bolts, which was Chex Mix, memory cells, which were M&Ms, which they also could have been Skittles or anything like that. We had computer chips, which were just chips, and we had dip and everything. Loose screws were the Fritos, like twisted Fritos. I think they're like honey barbecue flavored. And then we had fuel. Whatever they wanted to drink was their fuel. I made these little, with those like cheese and breadstick little packets that you can put in your lunch or whatever. Like I used to eat them when I was a kid a lot. I made those into little robots for them. So we had that. And then we got to talk about the book. We got to talk about survival instincts, survival tips and things like that, and different animal adaptations, which was really fun because we got to have a lot of science in this book, which we don't get very often in our books. And so that was really fun. And then I had the kids design their own robot and tell me why they designed it a certain way, what different features it had, and all that kind of fun stuff. They really enjoyed that. So this was probably one of my favorite events as well with them. And now we are reading this month in September. We are reading Midnight at the Barclay Hotel by Flora Bradley. And let me tell you guys, this is my second favorite behind Coraline that we have read together so far. This is a great mystery novel which follows, it's kind of like a middle grade Clue. If you like Clue, I think you'll probably like this one. It's a little paranormal, it's a little mystery like, and oh, it's just awesome. I don't want to tell you too much about it because I'm repeating myself at this point because I've talked about these books already, but I'm pretty sure my kiddos, this is one of their favorites as well. Once again, I love the illustrations in this, and I'm so excited for more books from Flora Bradley because, oh my goodness, was this good. So we are going to be talking about this one in October. And then next month, let me grab the book we've got for next month. Okay, so next month we will be reading Scritch Scratch. They picked this book, and I was like, you guys are going to get scared out of your pants because if you just read the back of this book, it tells like an excerpt from the book and it's just borderline creepy. So I'm super stoked to read this one with them. Hopefully they won't get too scared. But yeah, those are the books that I have read with my book club. So I think I covered everything, but I just wanted to share that with you guys today because this is such a huge part of my life. I mean, I only get to see them like once or twice a month, but it's still, I don't know. My heart is with these kids. My heart is with this book club. I love that I get the opportunity to do this. And I wanted to share this, one, for any parents or teachers out there that might want some recommendations of books they can do read-alouds with their kiddos or just books to recommend to their kiddos. I also thought it would be a good idea for anybody that was interested in starting a middle grade book club and wanted to kind of see how that works. This is kind of how I ran mine. At this point, since I've gotten out of the library, the parents will buy their own books for their kids. I don't bulk buy the books for the kiddos right now, so they will buy their own books, and I always tell them where they can get them the cheapest, and then they also help to bring in snacks right now. That way, it's not all heavy on me, and then we have a place to meet, so it's really awesome. If you ever get the opportunity to do anything like this, if you love kids, if you love books, this is such a fun thing to do. And hopefully you got some tips today. And if not, and you're just watching because you thought this was interesting or because you love middle grade, then I hope you found some really awesome middle grades here today as well. So I just want to say thank you, first of all, to all of the parents out there that allow their kids to participate in the book club with me. And thank you to all of my kiddos. I love you guys so much. I think you already know I spoil you guys to death, but then again, you guys also spoil me. I could not be more happy to have the opportunity to do book club with you guys. And to all of my subscribers and viewers out there, thank you so much for watching and supporting me. And I really enjoyed talking to you guys about something that was very near and dear to my heart today. I hope you guys all have a wonderful rest of your day, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye, friends.